Hey guys! As you might have noticed, the all-new Raspberry Pi Zero 2W was released just recently. Now, such a release of a new Raspberry Pi model is always exciting for us, especially since we're distributing our own customized Raspberry Pi image for our MoBro monitoring software. Yeah, we're a bit late for the general release reviews, but that won't stop us from doing one anyways. And we're gonna focus on the usage for MoBro, so let's get started! So here it is, the new Raspberry Pi Zero 2W. Now I know, it doesn't really look all that exciting or special, and it was even delivered without a box, just wrapped up in this bubble wrap over here. So we can't even do a nice unboxing. But despite its unspectacular appearance, this little thing here is actually a long-awaited upgrade over its predecessor and actually pretty awesome. Just let me explain. You might have already seen the regular, bigger Raspberry Pi models. We've got the Raspberry Pi 3 over here, for example. Now those are basically full computers with all the required hardware and ports like USB, HDMI, LAN ports, etc. right on this single board. People are using them for all kinds of projects, as they are affordable and quite small in size. Just have a look over here on YouTube and you will find all kinds of awesome and sometimes crazy Raspberry Pi projects, such as ours, for example. Now imagine you're doing such a project and all you want is to connect your Raspberry Pi to a display to visualize some nice stuff. Now you don't need any of those USB or LAN ports, also you might just prefer something that's even smaller than those regular sized Raspberry Pi models. Here's the Raspberry Pi Zero W. The original one was introduced back in 2015 with the wireless version that we got here in 2017. This can basically do all the same things as the bigger counterparts here. But naturally, due to the sizing constraints, the hardware specs are rather modest in comparison. Nevertheless, we have also used it for our MoBro monitoring software, since it's very cheap, small and doesn't require much power. So little, in fact, that you can directly power it from your motherboard's USB header in most cases. But more on that in our How to Power your Raspberry Pi video. Now, while this all sounds nice, the dated low-power hardware of the original Pi Zero has become limiting for some use cases. And it also shows when using it for MoBro. As you can see here, it's running, which is great. But once we're pushing it a bit by displaying lots of values, you will notice that the graph animations and the whole scene can become pretty choppy and lag. That is because the original Pi Zero W over here only has a single RM11 processor core available running at 1 GHz. By having Chrome running to load this monitoring scene here, we're already fully maxing it out, and as you can see here, when logged in over the console, yeah, that poor little CPU core is basically pinned to 100% usage all the time. So here's where it gets exciting for us with the new Raspberry Pi Zero 2W. While there are also other minor changes, the most notable one for us is the upgrade to 4 Cortex A53 cores. So not only is each of those cores faster than the previous single one, but we're also getting 4 of them. Now the available RAM didn't increase though and stayed the same at 512 MB. We would have actually liked to see a bump to 1 GB, but I guess you can't have everything. Especially when you're taking the still aggressive price point of just $15 into account. Now, to visualize the performance increase, let's take both of them, the old Zero W and the new Zero 2W, and load them with a flashed SD card with the identical pre-configured MoBro image on them. Now let's switch them on at the exact same time. And as you can see, the new Zero 2W has already almost completely loaded the scene. With the old model here, yeah, it's still trying. Also, this is the very same scene that was lagging pretty badly on the original Pi Zero W before, and now it runs just fine on the Zero 2W. If you're interested in actual benchmark numbers for comparison, just have a quick look here on YouTube and you will find multiple great videos already covering that. So we won't bother to do that again in this one, as we're keeping our focus on MoBro. But if you'd like us to do that kind of content as well in the future, just let us know down in the comments below. So, now that the performance penalties of the original Pi Zero are mostly gone, this new Pi Zero 2W provides a viable alternative to the bigger models like the Raspberry Pi 3 or the Raspberry Pi 4. It is a lot cheaper, a lot smaller, and also its power requirements are way lower. So in our opinion, this Raspberry Pi model might just be the one that strikes the best balance for performance, price and power requirements to be used for MoBro. And as an additional feature, both the Raspberry Pi Zero and Zero 2 can make use of the USB gadget mode, which allows them to use the micro USB port for both data and power at the same time. This basically means that you only need a single USB cable connected to your motherboard and you can use it for both power and data transmission for your MoBro hardware monitoring. There's no Wi-Fi, Ethernet or separate power connection required. This feature is unique to the Raspberry Pi 0 and 0 2 and you won't be able to use it on other models like the Raspberry Pi 3 or 4, as they physically can't transmit data over their USB power port and will also likely require more power than your motherboard's USB header is able to provide. If you want to learn more about that, again, watch our How to Power your Raspberry Pi video. Tell us what you think in the comments down below. Is it the right Raspberry Pi model for you and what would you wish for in a future hardware update? If you want to order one and support our channel with no additional cost on your end, you can always use the affiliate links in the description. If you liked the video, there's a whole lot more of hardware content on our channel and make sure to toss a like and as always, see you guys next time.